हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर कल्पेश पटेल, इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम द महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। आवर सब्जेक्ट इज पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फ्रॉम द बी थर्ड ईयर फिफ्थ सेम्स एंड द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 3140915। आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज पावर स्विचिंग डिवाइसेस। दिस इज द फ्लो ऑफ कंटेंट ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट सब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम विच we completed the static characteristics of the thyristor and the operation of the power devices as a switching in previous lectures. So in this lecture we will conduct the single quadrant switches and two quadrant switches. So first, single quadrant switches. This is the first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third, and this is fourth quadrant. If you consider the normal switch or a toggle switch, so it is on and off by manually. If the switch is opens, that means no current will be flow from terminal 1 to terminal 0. No current will be flow. So fully voltage appear across the two terminals 1 and 0, which is V plus and minus. So when switch is off conditions, so positive voltage V is appear across the switch. If we close this switch, so now current will flow from 1 to 2. So this is the positive current will be flow. So that means switch is on state, the positive current I will be flow. So this type of switch is known as the first quadrant switch or single quadrant switch, in which it conduct the positive current when on, and when switch is off, the voltage appear across the switch is V volt plus V. So it is the first quadrant switch. So in first quadrant, voltage is positive and current is also positive. In second quadrant, voltage become negative and current is positive. In third quadrant, both are voltage as well as current are negatives. In fourth quadrant, current is negative and the voltage is positive. So these are the four quadrants of the switch in which the different types of switch will operate. So we decide at particular application where we need the which kind of switch operations. So single quadrant switch, this is in which the voltage is positive and current is also positive. So this is the current bidirectional two quadrant switch. Current bidirectional, that means current is positive as well as the negative. So this is the positive current and this is the negative current, but voltage is only positive. So this is the two quadrant switch, but current bidirectional, current is positive as well as negative and voltage is positive only. So it is known as the current bidirectional two quadrant switch. Voltage bidirectional two quadrant switch, that means voltage bidirectional, so in which voltage is positive and voltage also negative, but current is only positive. So this is known, this type of switch is known as the voltage bidirectional two quadrant switch. And this is the four quadrant switch, that means which will operate in all the quadrants: positive current, positive voltage, and negative current, negative voltage. A single quadrant switches. First is active switch. Switch state is controlled by the third terminal. That means switch state is on or off is controlled by the third terminal, like BJT and MOSFET. So when we apply the gate signal to the MOSFET, MOSFET will turn on. If we remove the gate signal from the gate terminal, so it will turn off. So on and off state of the MOSFET is controlled by the third terminal gate. So it is known as the active switch. What is passive switch? In which the switch state is controlled by the applied current or voltage across its two terminals. So active switch is a three terminal device, while the passive switch is only two terminal device. That means its state is decided by the whatever the voltage or current applied to the two terminal of the switch. SCI is a special case switch. That means when we apply the gate signal to the SCR, SCR will turn on. Once the SCR will turn on, gate lost the control. That means we can't turn off the SCR by removing the gate signals. So this is the special case in which turn on process is known as the active, but turn off process is a passive. So in single quadrant switch, on state current IT and off state voltage VT are unipolar. That means in single quadrant switch, either voltage is positive or a negative. And voltage is positive or negative. So in first quadrant, voltage and current both are positive, so it is unipolar. In second quadrant, also current is positive but voltage is negative, so it is also unipolar. In third quadrant, both are negatives, and in fourth quadrant, voltage is positive and current is negative. The diode. So diode, it has only two terminals, anode and cathode. So it is a passive switch. If we applied the positive to the anode and applied negative to the cathode, so diode is in forward bias condition. That means it conducts the current from positive to negative. So the current characteristic is positive. But we applied the negative plus to the anode and negative to the cathode. So this is the reverse bias condition. So in this region, diode is turn off conditions. So fully negative voltage appear across its junction. So this is the negative voltage characteristic. So diode will operate in second regions. So it is a single quadrant switch but operate in second regions. So it conduct the positive state current, and while diode is in off condition, so it block the negative voltage. Now BJT and IGBT. So basic symbolic representation of BJT is here. One terminal 1, which is the collector, and second terminal 0 is emitter, and third terminal is C, controlled terminal. So it is a active switch. So it is the state on or off is controlled by the terminal C. If we applied the positive to the collector and negative to the emitter of NPN transistor, so when we not applied any control signals, it is in off state conditions. So fully voltage V appear across the switch. So this is the positive voltage. If we applied the gate signal to the control terminal C with respect to the emitter, so device will turn on and conduct the positive current from terminal 1 to terminal 2. So this is the positive current. So BJT will operate in this region, which is first quadrant region, in which the voltage and current both are the positive. So it is a single quadrant switch. Same IGBT is the, when we apply the gate signal, it will conduct, and when we remove the gate signal, the IGBT will turn off. It is also the single quadrant switch and first quadrant switch. So can conduct positive on state current and block when the switch is off. Now MOSFET. So MOSFET has also three terminals: drain, source and gate. So state of the MOSFET, either on or off, is controlled by the third terminal gate. So it is the active switch. If we applied the positives to the drain, which is N channel MOSFET, and negative to the source, so if we not apply any gate signals, the MOSFET state is off. So fully voltage V, positive voltage, appear across its two terminal, drain and source. So it is the positive voltage in off state conditions. If we applied the gate signal, positive gate signal, with respect to the source, the MOSFET will turn on and conduct the current from drain to the so positive currents. So its characteristics is positive currents. So in this condition, MOSFET will operate in first quadrant, has the positive voltage during off condition and positive current during the on conditions. And this is the reverse conduction, which is the special case in which if the we consider the MOSFET has a body diode in anti-parallel of the between the two terminals drain and source. So this is we will study in next slide how the reverse conduction will occur in the MOSFET and negative current will be flow. So it conduct the positive currents while on states and block the positive off state voltage. So MOSFET will operate in two regions, first regions and fourth regions. Now we realize the how the switch is selected, how switch is selected with the operations and the requirement. So we consider the one example of buck converter. In buck converter there is two switch A and switch B, three components L, C and voltage source. Here R is the load. So if switch A is open, that means fully voltage VG appear across its two terminal, which is VA. So it is the positive voltage across its two terminals. So positive voltage VA is VG. While switch is A is on condition, that means it conduct the current, positive currents from terminal 1 to terminal 2. So it is the positive current. So it is positive current. So switch A will operate in first quadrants. So switch, now we consider the switch B. Now switch A is open and switch B is also open. When switch A is open, the current will flow from inductor to capacitor and capacitor to source, also from load to the source. So in this conditions, capacitor will charge upper plate positive and lower plate negative. If we remove or open the switch A and close switch B, so current will IB will flow from this direct in this directions. So we all know the inductor release the energy in the same directions. That means this IL current will flow from IL through capacitor and capacitor through switch B and B through inductors. So in these conditions the current is positive, but when switch B is open, so lower terminal will be positive and upper is negative, so negative voltage appear across the switch B. So the requirement of the switch B is its on state current is positive but off state voltage is negative. And the requirement of the switch A is when switch A is off condition, the voltage is positive, and when switch is on conditions, the current is positive. So from the this so we decide which kind of switch will be selected from the characteristics. So this is the first quadrant switch. The requirement is first quadrant. So switch A will be replaced by the BJT, and the switch B requirement is current is positive and voltage is negative. So current is positive and voltage is negative. So switch B is replaced by the diode. So the in chop buck converter or in chopper converter, switch A is selected as the BJT or MOSFET, while the switch B is selected as the diode. So the realization of buck converter using the single quadrant switch is, so switch A is replaced by the BJT or a MOSFET, and switch B is replaced by the diode. So if a BJT is turned on, current is flowing from source to inductor, inductor to the capacitor, and capacitor to the negative of the source, also from load resistance, resistance to negative of the source, while switch A is off. So in this, inductor will charge from this plate is positive and this is negative, but when switch A is off, so inductor has the characteristics which release the energy in the same directions. So it release the energy in same directions as it store the energy. But this switch is off, so it is open. So now the current is flow from this direction also through the load. When switch A is on, so here is positive voltage and here is a negative voltage. So the diode is in reverse bias conditions. So no current will be flow from cathode to anode. But when switch A is opened and inductor release the energy in same direction, so this terminal become positive. So it is the anode and this is the cathode. So now it is in forward bias conditions. So current is flow from anode to cathode. Close the circuit through inductor and the parallel combination of the capacitor and the resistance. So this is switch A which operate in plus voltage and plus current, and this is the diode characteristics which operate in off state voltage negative and positive current. Now two quadrant switches which will operate in any two quadrants, like in these quadrants voltage is positive and current is bidirectional, but in this quadrant voltage is positive and current is positive and voltage is bidirectional. In these regions current is bidirectional and voltage is negative. In these regions voltage is bidirectional and current is negative. So this is the current bidirectional two quadrant switch. Now the current bidirectional two quadrant switch is, if we connect the diode in reverse bias conditions anti-parallel with the two terminal of the MOSFET or BJT, this is the drain or collector and this is the source or emitters. So diode connected in these manners. So if we connect the positive to terminal 1 and negative to terminal 0, the diode is in reverse bias condition. That means no current will be flow from terminal 1 to terminal 2. Also gate is not applied. So this device BJT or a MOSFET also is in off state condition. So no current will be flow from terminal 1 to terminal 0. So during in off conditions voltage is positive. If we applied the gate signals, so the device will turn on. So it conduct the current from terminal 1 to terminal 2. It is the positive currents. So it from its characteristics it is a positive current. So it is on state, transistor will conduct. So it conduct the positive currents. If we applied the positive to the zero terminal and negative to terminal 1, so this diode, this is the anode and this is the cathode. So anode is connected with positive, so diode is in forward bias condition. That means current is flow from anode to cathode in this direction, which is the negative currents. So from the characteristics this is the negative currents. In this region diode will conduct. So to make the transistors in two quadrant switch, we have to connect diode in such a manner. So this combination is known as the current bidirectional two quadrant switches. So it is the active switch and controlled by the terminal C, normally operated in two quadrants, first quadrant and fourth quadrants. Conduct positive or a negative current. So current is positive either a negative, and block the off state voltage, which is the only positive. MOSFET body diode. This is the same as the transistor. So the transistor is replaced by the MOSFET and connected anti-pillar with the diode. So MOSFET is also the two quadrant switches, first quadrant and second quadrant, same as the BJT. Now bidirectional battery charger or discharger. So this is the basic circuit of the DC to DC converter with bidirectional power flow. Bidirectional, that means power will flow in both directions from V bus to the battery as well as from battery to V bus. Here V bus is greater than the V battery. Suppose we consider the V bus is like a 230 volt and battery is like a 24 volt. So V bus is greater than the V battery. If we want to flow the power from V bus to the battery, so we have to step down this 230 volts into the 24 volt. If we want to flow the power from battery to V bus, we have to step up the 24 volt to the 230 volts. So when power is flow from V bus to V battery, so this converter will work as a step down converter. When the power is flow from battery to the V bus, this converter will operate as a step up converter. So step down is a buck converter and step up is a boost converter. So now we will consider first the buck converter. So it convert the 230 volt into 24 volt to charge the battery. So in this, as I explained in previous slide, the buck converter will step down the voltage. So in this conditions, transistor Q1 will operate. So transistor Q1 is switched on, current is flow from transistor to inductor, inductor to battery, and battery to the source. When transistor Q1 is off conditions, so now the diode D2 is in forward bias condition and inductor L will release the energy in the same directions. So current is flow in these directions. So when Q1 is operated, turn on and turn off by the Q1 driver circuit, so this converter operate as the buck converters. Now we consider if we want to supply the power from battery to the V bus, this converter operate as a boost converter. That means it boosts up the voltage from 24 volt to 230 volts. So in these conditions, the transistor TQ2 will operate. So if we applied the gate signal to the transistor Q2, transistor Q2 will turn on and it store the current is flow from inductor to transistor to battery. So in this condition, inductor will charge with this plate positive and this plate negative. If we remove the gate supply from the transistors, so transistor become turned off. But as we know, the inductor release in the same direction energy. First, it energy is flowing from, well, inductor is charging, current is flowing from this terminal to this terminal. So inductor will release the energy in the same directions when transistor is in off condition. So in these conditions, this terminal become positive and this terminal become negative. So this 24 volt plus voltage across the inductor, both are connected in series. So this 24 volt and this inductor voltage are connected in series. So this voltage become higher than the 24 volt and is the current is flow from this inductor to diode D1 to the source and source to the negative. So when transistor Q2 will operate, this converter will work as a boost converter. When the transistor Q1 will operate, the converter work as a buck converter. Voltage bidirectional two quadrant switches. This is the transistor and this is diode. If you connect diode in such a manner, this combination of the switch will operate voltage bidirectional two quadrant switches. So if we applied positive to terminal 1 and negative to terminal 0, but no gate voltage is applied, so transistor is in off condition. So fully voltage, positive voltage V, appear across its two terminal 1 and 0. So in this situation, voltage is positive when the transistor is off condition and it's block the positive voltage. If we apply the gate signals at control terminal positive with respect to ground, the transistor will turn on and it conduct current, positive current, from terminal 1 to terminal 0. So in this situation, current is positive when transistor is in on conditions. If we applied the positive to terminal 0 and negative to terminal 1, so in these conditions, diode is in reverse bias conditions. So diode will block the voltage. So it is the fully voltage, negative voltage appear across terminal 1 and terminal 0. So it is the negative voltage. So this kind of combination of BJT and diode, the switch will operate in voltage bidirectional and current positive. So it is two quadrant switches, voltage bidirectional and current is positive. GTU questions. Explain the realization of the power electronic switches as a single quadrant switches and two quadrant switches, in which you have to explain how the different kind of switches like BJT, MOSFET, IGBT and diode will operate in different kind of regions if we connect the reverse bias condition or a forward bias conditions. So in this lecture we completed up to the single quadrant switches and two quadrant switches. So in next lecture we will conduct the firing circuit for the thyristors and gate driver circuit for the MOSFET and IGBT. Firing circuit and gate driver circuit, that means how to turn on the thyristors and how to turn on the MOSFET and IGBT. Thank you.